incorporated non-profit yet pays no taxes.
Yeah.
All heard yourself then.
But I might
say that's loud.
Sounds okay.
Cut her down just.
Well, it's nice to meet you folks. Had a hillbilly. Mm-hmm. How many of you ever saw a hillbilly?
Ah.
Yeah. You know, I found out that hillbillies are very important. In fact, I've always known they were important. But I've met people that didn't like hillbillies. They thought it was a slang name that was detrimental to the world. But anyway, I met a fellow one time, a lady one is a hillbilly. And she said, I was talking to her. She said, I'd like, could you tell me where to find a real hillbilly? And I said, well, I guess I'm one. So she said, so you got shoes on and you don't have patches on your breeches? And I said, no. I went barefooted when I was 21 years old. And I said, you meant rocks and salt rocks, really rough on your feet. But I said, they were so tough. She said, but you're like so heavy because I'd really tough them up. And I said, since you asked me the question, I'd like to tell you. I'd like to ask you a question. I said, did you ever see a hillbilly looking for a city dude? They said, don't think you ever did. Well, I said, that shows you who's important, you see, because city dudes are looking for hillbillies. But anyway, I was going to tell you about the mule I had. You heard about these Missouri mules? All mule in the yard wide? It's pretty wide for a mule, you know, but he was the funniest mule I ever saw. So, I tell this to kids mostly, but it's funny, dogs. I said, that was the pulliest mule ever I saw. I never hit the mule, he didn't move. But I said, I was working down in Louisiana in the river mines, who was by sea river mines, and I said, I was dragging that river out. It was blowing out of that mine, and I was dragging down the sheds, put on the guard, you know. And I hit it, blew out a chunk there about as big as a house, and I said, I hit that mule over one corner of it, and I cracked my whip, and he started pulling, and the more he pulled, I said, the river just kept stretching, getting tighter and tighter and tighter. And I said, the further he went, the tighter it got. And I said, finally the mule got stretching, the river started pulling. I said, that was something to see. So I said, I think the old mule gets up on his toe, gets all he hold. I thought he was going to move him. So I think the next time he'll move it. I said, I cracked my whip again, that mule made a little lunge at that. And I said, his feet flew out from under him, and he's kept scratching his claws, trying to hold on to his leg off from up to his knee, just running at my mule. Have you ever heard that? I tell that to kids, they get a kick at it. Another time I met about four or five kids out of squirrel hunting down the old logging roads, you know. And I met these kids, and I like to talk to kids because I love kids. And I would tell them about what the great possibilities were of the human race and what, you know, how great a boy could be if he took advantage of this world and worked for the sweat of his brow. And I wouldn't get too far away and finally I said, tell you boys what I can do. I'll bet you 200 I can lift a ton in 5 seconds. They said, you can't lift 100 pounds in 5 seconds. Well, I said, I'll tell you, I've got my faith in myself and my abilities. And I said, I'll just demonstrate to you what I can lift a ton in 5 seconds. Well, they said, we don't believe it, but we'd like to see you. So I said, okay, and I had a watch like this, you know, and I took it out and I handed one of the kids and I said, can you tell the time? He said, yeah, I said, about 12 years old, my goldsmith. I said, can you read that second hand? And he said, yeah. Well, I said, get her on the marker where you can tell how long it takes me to lift this ton. And if I don't lift a ton in 5 seconds, I give you boys 2 to 1. 50 cents piece, a dollar piece. So I was just ready to start lifting, you know, and I said, when you get ready to lift, you tell me when to start. And he told me when to go in there, and I did up there like a fella, you know, squatting for maybe 100 yard dash. When he said go, I just started down the old road, just pick him up and set him around way over here. I got there and I said, say, how long was I? How long have I done this? And he said, 4 seconds. I said, my God, I done better than I thought. I said, I fooled myself. But he said, we don't understand how you lifted that ton and how you did it. Well, I said, I tell you boys, I said, you boys got 2 good eyes. I said, there's 5 of us, 10 good eyes here, and you didn't use them. And I said, if you don't use what God gave you, you'll take it away from you. And I said, another thing, I said, if you'd been, you can hear me if you listen, because every time I hit that ground, I popped the gravel. But They said, well, we'd like to know how you done that, how you lifted that ton. I said, we didn't see it. I said, yeah. I said, you didn't use what God gave you. So I proceeded to tell them, I said, well, I weigh about 145 pounds with the shoes on. And I said, every time I got over one foot, I said, I had both feet off the ground, hit the ground, I lifted 145 pounds. I said, I counted the steps out there, there's 21 steps. But I said, to make it easy to figure this, I said, you boys supposed to have a brain. I said, we just got it down to 20. And I said, how much is it? A ton. And one boy said, 2,000 pounds. I said, yeah, that's a short ton. But he said, how did you do that? Well, I said, I weigh 145 pounds. I lift that every time I got off one foot on the other, which I did. Old Killy's heel lifter. So, I asked him how much 145 pounds times 20 was. They couldn't figure that. I said, yeah, God gave you a brain to figure with, and you couldn't figure it. I said, if you don't use what God gave you, there'll not be anything in this world. So I said, well, when he said it's 4 seconds, I said, well, I fooled myself. I said, you know, 145 times 20 is 2,900 pounds. That's a ton, and what it is. But I said, I lift some more than a ton. And I said, not only that, but I threw it in one step, and that made it easy to figure. We said, we wouldn't have believed it. I said, you don't even use what faith God gave you. So I said, if you don't use what you got, God gave you, you'll never amount to anything in this world. And that's it. you know, that's a story I made right on the spot. And I've got some others that I have told in my time. I tell about the story of the silver lord with the face up. And the features of the great stone face, they're all very moral stories, you see. And I like to tell them to kids. In fact, a lady told me in church the other night, the story of the great stone face, features of the great stone face. And so I guess that'd be enough for tonight. So good night. Thank you.
Thank you.